codesource.net.
Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. This is an updated guide for scrcpy, the little program for Windows and Android, Mac as well, that allows you to share and control your Android device from your computer. Now it's super awesome, and now that the updates are out, it's super easy to use. And we've done a video in the past that was super popular, but it was a little bit more complicated back then, and the new version supports Android 10 better. So let's get started. Basically, it will allow you to control your phone from your computer with your mouse and keyboard. It's really good and really easy to use. So first thing you need to do is head on over to the GitHub page. I'll leave a link in the description below. Once you've done that, scroll on down and download the Windows zip file for version 1.17, or if there's a newer one out, you can probably grab that as well. It should be the same installation moving forward for a while. Once you've done that, we can set up the Android aspect. So while that's downloading, head on over to your Android device and make sure you have developer options enabled. This will be different for whatever device you have, so just Google how to do that, then do it. Once you've got it enabled, you'll see developer options at the bottom of the screen. Tap that, then scroll down and make sure USB debugging is turned on. Now, there is also another option. I'll put it up on the screen here. And you need to make sure this is enabled as well to get keyboard and mouse support. If you don't, you won't be able to. It basically just gives you the visibility. You won't be able to do any controlling. So make sure that's enabled as well. Apart from that, you need to make sure when you log into your phone and have it connected that you have file sharing enabled. So this option here, it should be a prompt at the bottom when you connect your cable, and it'll allow you to choose between one of the options, but transferring files is a must, as well as developer options. If you have this problem where you don't get this option, you might be using a charge only cable, so make sure the cable you're using does have file transferability, otherwise you won't see it. So once you have those options enabled, the rest of the process is pretty straightforward. Okay, back on track. So once you've got the file downloaded, you need to extract it, as we just mentioned. And one second. Okay, enter the folder, and you've got a range of files here. So the most important one is going to be this one and this one. If you use this, you'll open with the console window, and it's kind of ugly having both windows open, so close that. And probably you're going to want to use a no console window, so this one here. And as you just saw, you can use as many instances as you want. You can also use multiple devices if you have multiple devices. So simple as double clicking on that, and you will get full control of your keyboard, mouse, whatever, as we showed earlier. Now, the next step, and probably the most important one once you've got it running, is to go back to the GitHub page, scroll right down towards the bottom, and make sure you go through the keyboard shortcuts. Just here, mod is Alt on the keyboard if you're confused. It took me a while to figure that one out. And then you can use a shortcut. Simply hold Alt, left, right, whatever, and you'll rotate the screen. It's probably the most commonly asked question. A lot of people had problems with that in the past, but they're all here and they work really good. Apart from that, the next most common question is audio forwarding. If you do want to forward audio, you need to add scrcpy. It's another program and it allows you to cast the audio. So simply download that. I believe there's an APK file in the folder. Install that on your Android device, and then you can open the file using a similar exe. I haven't done that yet. If people do get stuck with it, I might make another video, but it's pretty straightforward, so we'll see how we go. Apart from that, I would also suggest spending some time reading through this page because there are a lot of commands that do a lot of interesting things. You can adjust the FPS, you can get rid of this little border at the top and a few other things. It's also possible to set up little scripts or batch files using these commands, so they'll all occur as it opens, but it's a little bit more advanced, and if you just want to use it for the basics, feel free. I believe that's everything. As always, if you do have any more questions, just shout out in the comments or find us on social media. There's plenty of places we're around. And as always, thanks for watching. Hopefully this was more helpful than the last one. It's a little bit dated now. And enjoy. Download source.net.